Everyone can hear me good. I'm up, hooked up. So the video there kind of talks through a little bit of the opportunities which this presentation will kind of get into. Some will be a little bit redundant from what Paul kind of went through, because a lot of the advancements are being worked on amongst multiple companies. But we'll kind of look at how digital can complement what you may traditionally be doing, whether that's screen or even, you know, if you're pad printing or doing some other unique processes, hot stamp or heat transfer. As Todd mentioned, my name's Tom Malfizi. I joined Firmac about 3 years ago, just after the last time we were all together. So it's been good to meet some of you. I've met a good amount of you over the few years I've been with the team, but it's nice to put some faces and names of folks as well. If you're not familiar with Firmac, we opened in 1993 and headquartered in Parma, Italy. The beginning part of the business was focused primarily on screen printing systems, fully automatic servo machines, like you saw earlier, as well as, you know, more mechanical, semi-automatic systems as well. In 2013, we started our development in the digital inkjet world, partnering with an ink supplier, a lot of robust testing and so forth. So we've come a long way, kind of how Paul said, the process has advanced over the past 7, 8, 10 years, and we're kind of in that same boat. So most of you, I guess I don't know everyone here, but product decorating to some degree, whether it's spraying or printing, and you know, it's either a passion or it's a necessary requirement of your business. And probably when it comes to digital, you may look at it in one of two ways. One being hesitant. You know, it is maturing, it's growing, it's developing. Some of you may be using it right now or have done more advanced testing with it, so you have a little more optimism with the process and what it can do to your business. As it relates to, you know, glassware, hollow glass containers, globally you can find it in different advancements, you know, in different, based on the different subsegments. So glassware may be more advanced, bottles it may be something new. It may be different whether it's in Europe versus US versus Mexico, you know, all different areas are kind of advancing at different rates. But hopefully, you know, as it continues to grow, you can become more comfortable with the technology and are comfortable in bringing it into your offerings. So no matter where you are in the process, whether you're investigating or currently doing it, the goal of this presentation really, and in general, I would encourage you to not view it as something that would replace what you're currently doing for printing. Digital, which we'll talk about, is complementary in nature. It's kind of a different approach, not a replacement for, say, for example, screen printing. There's still definitely things that screen has advantages for that currently digital is not there, but it can be viewed as definitely a complement. We'll get into some areas here, but you know, digital can help you reorganize your workflows, can maybe bring some different revenue opportunities to the business. So before we get into that, you know, there's typically two areas that you'll look at with digital. The first one being, do you need it? And when you're thinking of do you need it, a lot that comes into play is, can my current personnel handle the process, the technology? It's different than traditional screen, as some of you may know. You know, it might help streamline workflows, but there's additional resources required. It might be a different skill set, an operator or lead person required. Also, if you're looking at, do we need it, what are your customers saying? You know, we're hearing a lot of buzz, a lot of interest in digital, but what's the end user really, what are their expectations with the printed product? What are they really asking for? Those are all questions that I'm sure if you're in the decorating business, you're all working through those scenarios to see if it makes sense for your business. Then the next question typically is, can you trust digital? That's where maybe some of this hesitancy might come in, or reservations, or just waiting to see how everything keeps developing. Digital printing is, maturing very rapidly. You know, I keep going to refer back to Paul because we have some overlap here on the digital side of things, but he kind of talked about what he was talking about 7 years ago, and there's been lots of development in that time. Other substrates as well, you know, Firmac specifically, We're focused on glassware, hollow glass containers, ceramics, some plastics, but even the textiles and other industries, you know, everything, the digital process is maturing, you know, across the board. You could even look at, you know, the photography industry, where that was years and years ago to where they've come now. They had some bumps along the way and growing and learning, but their developments now, you know, it's a totally different market. Definitely still limitations to the process, which I'll touch on, but in general, digital is a reliable technology with advancements made, you know, daily, weekly. So when I mentioned, you might have read the introductory or, you know, for the presentation, we want to talk a little bit just about how digital can complement your traditional ways of printing, with complement being the key word. Screen, for example, certainly offers advantage when you're trying to print small or fine text in detail. You know, Pantone colors, color matching, things along those lines. You know, you're still gonna, if you need a specific Pantone, you're still gonna wanna rely on screen or even larger printable areas. Now I know Paul said there's been some advancements, but higher volume, larger printable areas. You know, traditionally screen has still been advantageous in that regard. But digital, it does provide a new era, kind of in glass decoration. And we've kind of highlighted 12 features, and I won't get into detail on all of them. I do have some additional slides here on some of them with some examples as well. But just looking at it, for example, variable data. You know, if you're looking for QR code or a data matrix or sequential numbering or a data-driven image, the value in digital, as most of us probably know, is the printing can be different, can potentially be different from the previous image and the one after. So having that capability. Small batches and prototyping are another one. You know, it can easily support small batches to medium runs. Definitely with the right equipment configuration, higher volume is attainable. But digital really offers you the opportunity for frequent art changeovers might be required, things along that nature. That's where digital can help. Full color, you know, as you're walking around at the exhibit yesterday, you might have saw some printed products with faces on them and things like that. That's definitely an area that digital can help in with continuous tone images and rich detail graphics. And then full bottle printing. You know, the latest generations of machines are designed with that capability to provide brands, you know, finer brands with wines or spirits, the option to personalize their products with dedicated messages or sequential numbering, or where you have, you know, special limited edition, one of 200 bottles, things like that, where they're able to really personalize and increase their revenue because they can mark those type of products off. At the same time, you know, with bottle printing, more and more testing and development on even doing some printing with packaged or capped bottles. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be, you know, we're not making contact, the part doesn't move as much in certain of the machines versus screen or so forth. You probably saw some of these type of examples around the show yesterday from our different colleagues here exhibiting. But mirroring effect is a unique feature of the digital process. It allows for mirroring, it allows for optimal legibility of the decoration for the printed product when viewing it both externally and internally. You're able to have that mirroring effect. And at the same time, you're able to control and achieve certain colors with screen printing, transparency, opaqueness. You can control those features a little bit differently with the digital process. 3D, Paul went into lots of detail on it, but some additional you know, pictures and examples. It's very unique, the way that the bottle aesthetic can change, or the glassware, whatever the article might be. You can, you know, basically have, you or your customers could have stocked inventory, and adding a feature like this, you're able to make it stand out on the shelf, you're able to add value to that product for without having to go to your glass manufacturer and try to get custom orders and all these, you know, that's not really attainable. But the embossing effect is, and the raised relief is definitely unique, and And you got a great example of with Paul going through the step-by-step of how that works. Another unique feature of digital, when you know compared to screen printing or so forth, is the capability for edge-to-edge printing, for printing on convex or complex shapes. Today's digital systems, Firmax included, and so forth, they're using an advanced object path management system. So they're able to decorate these shapes precisely matching object specifications. As you may or may not know, you know, the digital ink, the head doesn't make contact with the part. So it allows you that flexibility or to adapt to different parts and geometries. You can decorate complex convex shapes, concave shapes, edge-to-edge printing, and also at the same time decorating raised embossings that might be on the glass, whether that's a numbering marking or a surface feature. There's a couple examples here. You really can achieve those that you're not worried about that making contact with the part. So it definitely opens up some new areas that traditional printing methods are limited in. Another unique feature, aside from the aesthetic look of the part, the quality of the print you're going to get and so forth, comes into the print on demand. This slide specifically is showcasing or going through a cloud-based solution that Firmac has developed with Bosch Rexroth. But to simplify it, basically it's when you're able to transfer that data or image, say directly from with the Krux software, directly from your tablet or smartphone to the machine and be printing really whatever you're looking to print. There were some samples we had yesterday showing, some faces on bottles, and it's always a unique feature when you're at a show with machines to, take your picture and 20 seconds later you're on a glass. But the digital technology makes that happen, makes that an option. So aside from the functionality of getting the image to the machine, other features with interfacing with your internal software or your internal management systems, you can incorporate, even a customer being able to purchase online on demand almost, where they upload their image if you have the right software, and if you are a business with online ordering and things like that, that all can all communicate. And they can have their names personalized, they can upload their image, and it goes right to the machine, and so forth. Just tying back into that natural ability of the process for small batches, minimal startup costs, and minimal costs, time and costs, I should say. Hot foil stamping is another unique, gets a little bit more advantageous with digital in the fact of personalizing when you're trying to get those metallic effects. Typically, as over the years, the primer would have to be applied to the glass for the foil to stick, whether it's screened, typically screen printed on. But today's, like we talked a little bit earlier, that primer can be jetted onto the article now, whatever it may be, and then whether that hot stamp pad is integrated into the machine or in an offline system. We show one here in a partnership we have with CER in ONL France, but now you're able to have a different image for every article. It could be different because now you're jetting that primer on, and the foil is a roller typically, and that foil is only sticking to where that primer is on the part. So you're able to add those metallic colors or those special effect foils, glossy different things, a lot of different effects you can get in foils and get them on the glass now. In a small batch type of run. We've seen that in cosmetic, we've seen on some bottles, and it's really unique. So the video kind of showed that in the beginning, more so obviously the first half of the video was based around sustainability and so forth, and the second half just kind of highlighting some of the opportunities that we've discussed. But if you're looking at environmental impact, digital, like UV screen and so forth, offers some ways to save, whether that's cost, improving your carbon footprint. I know that's come up in a few discussions today. The digital plays into that role as well. When printing a glass digitally, for example, you know, with the use of LED lamps, organic inks, and so forth, I think some studies have shown that you could save, you know, around even 80% of the energy required from screen printing or in using 1/5 of the power. So there's definitely advantages on that side, different from the aesthetic look or the functionality of the process. At the same time, typically digital, you know, inkjetted products, as long as there's no other features on it, you know, coatings or different things, depending on what they are, can be 100% recycled as well. So with the process, the inks will sublimate during the recycling process at those temperatures. So just another feature. I know the gentleman earlier, Tony, mentioned how all these changes that we could see coming down in the future, 2 years out, 3 years out on legislation and so forth, digital plays right kind of into that and supporting you and, you know, meeting those demands. Basically, this is just a step-by-step of a standard linear process. You know, you've got your primer, your white, your CMYK, your top coat. What can be very interesting, and we know we addressed it a little bit earlier, is if you were to add, say, screen print into the mix, you know, a hybrid type system, you know, somewhere after that CMYK application, you could integrate screen printing stations, UV screen, and so forth. So now if you had digital, now it's even more flexible because you're able to print digital with screen. You could use the system just running digital, or you could even use it just to run screen if, you know, based on your production requirements and your scheduling demands. Just a couple more here from my side. In the marketplace in general, there's a variety of machines, options. There's ones that could be considered more smaller footprint, smaller volume, there's medium range, there's higher output. You know, there's definitely, there's a solution for what your needs are, depending on where you are in your process, where you are in your investigation of the technology, even where you are in your market. You know, maybe having a higher output just doesn't make sense, but there's linear versions, there's smaller versions. They're all at different stages of development. For Firmac specifically, just to kind of introduce our range as I wrap up a little bit here, you know, we have linear, simple production machines are out there. There's, you know, the two up linear production machines based on a little higher price point, little better output, different styles of rotaries, and obviously then the hybrid machine where you're mixing digital with UV LED screen printing. But in general, I mean, I know this is my first SGCD, so I can't say I've listened, been here for all the past introductions of digital. But I hope some of you, if it's new or if you're investigating it, can see some of the ways it can complement your technology. By no means, you know, Firmac, we're, at least speaking of us, screen is still very much, very prevalent, very much the bulk of our machine screen. We have maybe 15 to 20 digital machines in the market, but it's growing. It's growing in the right applications, the right customer, the right applications, the right end user market based on what they're trying to achieve. And it's really important to understand, which I'm sure most of you have as you talk with your customers, if your customer is willing to accept the result of digital printing. You know, it's a little different than screen, so they have to have a good understanding of what that result will be coming off of the machine. You know, if they're used to high-end spirits, used to a screen printed image, and now they want to go digital, there's a little difference. So it's good to have those conversations and be upfront. And, you know, as suppliers to the industry, I'm sure I would speak for all of us, we're all more than willing to be part of those discussions and help you educate your end users. So that's all I had. It was kind of quick. I just wanted to get through the complimentary things, but thanks for having us, and thank you everyone for sitting in. So. Yeah.